Okay, we'll chant some of the previous names of Puja Gurudev and then we'll add one more tonight. You can repeat these names, they're very simple. They're all names from Upanishads and Shastras.
Om Tapo Vanashishyaya Namaha.
Om Tapo Vanashishyaya Namaha.
Om Tapasrine Namaha.
Om Tapasrine Namaha.
Om Tapanashanaya Namaha.
Om Tapanashanaya Namaha.
Om Tejasvine Namaha.
Om Tejasvine Namaha.
Om Tirthaswarupaya Namaha.
Om Tirthaswarupaya Namaha.
Om Dehatitaya Namaha.
Om Dehatitaya Namaha.
Om Dvandvatitaya Namaha.
Om Dvandvatitaya Namaha.
Om Drihanishchayaya Namaha.
Om Drihanishchayaya Namaha.
Om Dharma Samsthapakaya Namaha.
Om Dharma Samsthapakaya Namaha.
Om Dhimate Namaha.
Om Dhimate Namaha.
Om Dhiraya Namaha.
Om
Dhairya Pradaya Namaha.
Om Dhairya Pradaya Namaha.
Om Narayanaya Namaha.
Om Narayanaya Namaha.
Om Nijanandaya Namaha.
Om Nijanandaya Namaha.
Om Nirapekshaya Namaha. Nirapekshaya Namaha.
Om Nirapekshaya Namaha.
Gurudev is called as Nirapeksha. Nirapeksha. I tell you that in Sanskrit there is a small little root called as Iksh. Iksh means to see, to look. You know, like when we in Trinidad language we call it scoping out. Iksh means to look or to see. Then in front of that Iksh is Apa. Apa is called the prefix. Upasarga in Sanskrit. So Apa plus Iksh is Apeksh. When you join up these two words, you get Apeksh. So Apa Iksh. Apa Iksh means, really now in Trini language, you're scoping out. Yeah. So when you go on, you know, instead of you thinking about God and thinking about divine and thinking about how nature is touched with the divinity of God and all that kind of thing, right? Instead of looking at that, well, you scoping out in nature and what I will get. You know, what covetable things are there, what I could carry home, what, you know? That's called as apaiksh. You seeing what you're not supposed to see. Instead of seeing God in all things, you seeing what I could take along with me when I go in. Apaiksh. So what is it? Then in front of that, another upasarga is put now. Nir. Nir means without in Sanskrit. Like nirmala. Mala means dirt. Nirmala means without dirt, without impurities. Like that. Nir. When you put in front of any word in Sanskrit, the opposite comes. Without that thing. So, nirlepana means in Sanskrit. This is Gita also. Not smear, unsmeared. So, like that. Hey, nirapeksha means the eyes are not going on. I could get this, I'll get that, or take this, I want that. His eyes are not like our eyes, you know, free from that. He looks, I am God, everything is God. What you could take from where to carry where? You see? That is part of me already. How will I take it and carry it where? You're already part of me. You can't take your foot and bring it home. Your foot is already part of you. So like everything in this world is part of him. So nirapeksha. His eyes are not going out there, you know, grabbing. We grab it on our eyes, eh?
Yeah.
Yeah. Like that. Nirapeksha. So what a nice name of... I told now these names and all are so good, we have to limit ourselves to just short commentary, and otherwise our yagna will get finished right there itself. So we are seeing chapter 8 of Srimad Bhagavad Gita, if you are joining us tonight for this first time, and we are coming from Temple Village, Verdant Vale, in, this is Arima?
Mm-hmm. Via Arima.
Via Arima.
This is Verdant Vale on the way to
Blanchishares. Yes. Blanchishares Road from Arima.
Via Arima.
Yeah. And those people who have not come to this little shrine here, built by Satji, you should come and visit him. This is the most divine place. The vibration and air, everything around is so nice. Last year, I remember distinctly we had such a great time here also. All right, so we are seeing Srimad Bhagavad Gita, and we are coming to you from this very divine little ashram way up in Verdant Vale via Arima. On the way to Blanchishares. Yes. And for those of you who are joining us tonight for the first time, today we had a very long walk all the way from Blanchishares to here. So, 24 kilometers we walked. And now everybody rested. Therefore, they're laughing so loudly. When they came here at lunchtime, nobody was laughing at that time. All laugh cut. I see that very, this is a good sign. The laughter has returned. Excellent. All right. So, this 8th chapter kicked off with Arjuna asking a few questions to Bhagavan. What is Brahma? What is Adhyatma? What is Adhibhutam? What is Adhidaivam? What is, you know, like that? Adhiyagnya. How do I know you at the time of death? So, those 7 questions which Arjuna put there, Bhagavan answered, I told you, 6 of them in 2 verses. Finish 6. If you did not listen last night, we ought to tell, I can't go back to the 6 questions. No. Oh, that was recorded. That was played today, Pandit? That was played today, Well, what happened? We were doing that from Ganga Dhara last night. And there was no data on phone data to send that thing. So today I think it would have been played on. So now, among those 7 questions, the last question Arjuna asked was, how am I to remember you at the time of death? Prayana kale cha katam neosi. Niyatatma, he means by people who are niyatatma. Niyatatma means one who is sadhak. That is a simple word, sadhak. Niyata means one who is controlling himself, one who is mastering his senses and his mind and his body, and who is mastering that. He's called as Niyata. Now, Niyatatma. Niyata Atma. Niyata means he mastering his mind and senses and all that. So, by those people, how are they to remember you and know you at the time of death? It's a very, very important question, eh? Because there is this teaching in Hinduism that if even at the time of death, you remember God in that last moment, that person will merge with God. That is his last thought that he leaves with. He'll merge with whatever last thought, God or any other thing. Whatever last thought we leave with, we become that. Make sure you don't think about monkey when you're dying. Some people say, oh, Swamiji, how you'll say that, you know. Now you'll make me think about monkey when I'm dying. And my next life, I'll become a monkey. That is not good. You never become the same thing in 2 lives. Don't worry. So anyway, how are we to remember you at the time of death? Now Bhagavan is going to discuss this question. And he himself introduces, now this will be verse number 5, we'll see. We saw up till 4 already yesterday.
Shri Krishna Sharanam Nama. Shri Krishna Sharanam Nama. Shri Krishna Sharanam Nama.
Antakale means at the end. End of time. End of our time. No, not end of time. No. Time doesn't end. We end, isn't it? Antakale means when we go in. Huh? When we say bye-bye to this world. Antakale chamameva smaran muktva kalevaram. When you're dropping this body. Kalevaram means you're dropping this body. Say, smaran muktva, remembering me and dropping this body. What happens? Yat prayati samadbhavam. That person comes and merges with me. He comes to me, merges with me. Yati na asti atra samshayaha. There is absolutely no doubt in this. That person merges with me. Arjuna said, but that is not what I asked you. I asked, how am I to remember you at the time of that? I know what you are telling. You say, that is the principle. Na? Bhagavan said, Arjuna, have little patience. Now I'm getting to the point just now. Bhagavan is just, you know, slowly getting to that point. He says, yam yam. No, the principle, other principle involved in this thing, which I just told you in the beginning also. This is from here only. He says, yam yam vapi smaran bhavam. Kesatyante kalevaram. Tamtame vaiti kaunteya. Sadatat bhava bhavitaha. That whatever you remember at the time of death, yam yam vapi smaran bhavam, whatever you're remembering at the time of death, whatever you're thinking about at the time of death, kalevaram, chetatyante kalevaram, dropping the body at that time, tam tam eva eti, you go straight to that thing, you become that only, whatever you entertain in the last thoughts. Why? Or how? And now that next phrase which he gives there is a very, very wonderful phrase. See, Bhagavan, I told you, he says many things without saying also. He says, sada tad bhava bhavitaha. Now that is not connected to what is going on in the... Listen to the whole verse. He says, yam yam vapi smaran bhavam, whatever you think about while you are dying, right? This is the first line. Tam tam eva eti, you go only to that. This last part of the verse is not connected to the story is complete. This last part says, sada tad bhava bhavidha, having thought about that all your life, but that is not connected to that. What do we mean then? The rabbi said, he's saying things without saying. It means to say, what you have thought about all your life, that is what you will think, Adi. Yeah, see, how wonderful. Because that first thought is finished. Having thought about something all your life, Revai, that only you will think about at the end of your life. Don't expect to think about something else. It will not work. You can't trick God. God always have one up his sleeve. You can't trick God. One man tried that. He heard that if you call God's name at the end of your life, you will reach God. He was a shopkeeper. So he named his four sons, you know, Brahma, Vishnu, Mahesh and Ganesh. So he said, when I'm dying, all my four sons will be there. So I will keep calling their name, Brahma, Vishnu, Mahesh and Ganesh. And then I will reach God because I'm calling their name only. And really when he was dying, the four sons were there. So, Brahma, you're here, yes. Vishnu, you're here, yes. Ganesh, Mahesh, you're here, yes. Ganesh, you're here. They were all saying, yes. And he went on calling all of them, Brahma, Vishnu, Mahesh, Ganesh. Brahma, Vishnu, Mahesh, Ganesh. Calling their name, waiting to die. He will utilize this principle in Gita. Then, Brahma, Vishnu, Mahesh, and he stopped. But if four of you are here, who's minding the shop? And he died. Chala gaya ye bechara. No, see, in his neckline must become a shop. The idea is that when you try to trick God, that thing will not work. Because whole life you're thinking about shop, money, selling, buying, making profit. How in the end, protecting your shop? So that's what it's talking about there. Because if four of them are here, who's protecting that? A shop. Whole life you're thinking about that. This is the meaning. Sada means always. That bhava bhavitaha. Keeping that thing close to your heart. That is what you kept close to your heart all your life. See, throughout this discussion, Bhagavan is using the word smaran. Smaran means remembering. But Bhagavan is here in this last part, he's using the word smaran. He said, sada tad bhava bhavitaha. Bhava means you're feeling that thing close to your heart. All your life. You use a smaran word. In this last pada. Your whole life, that thing is the closest thing to your heart. What do you remember at the end? That only. Tasmat, the next verse says, Sarveshu Kaleshu, at all times, all places, every time, all the time, Sadaya, Ma Manusmara, therefore remember? Me, you don't try to remember shop and then in the end you don't remember? Therefore the next verse starts with Tasmat, therefore, all your life you remember? Me, Tasmat, Sarveshu Kaleshu, at all times, Ma Manusmara. Remember me and do what? Yudhyacha. In Arjuna's case, yudhya means fight. In Arjuna's case, fight. In our case, do your duty. Remember me and do your duty. And now, Arjuna said, Prabhu, that too I didn't ask you. I asked you how to remember you. Katam yeyosi. How am I to know you at the time of death? So Bhagavan gives his hint here, but it is not clear for us. Means your whole life remember me. Then only the end you will remember. But Arjuna looks at me, but how to do that? Whole life remember you. Bhagavan says, Mai arpita mano buddhihi mame vaishyasya samshayam. Mai arpita manaha buddhihi. Surrender your mind and intellect to Arjuna said, Prabhu, you tell me one more difficult thing upon another difficult thing. First you said, to remember you my whole life. Then when I asked, well, how to remember you my whole life? You say, surrender your mind and intellect to me. But that also is such a difficult thing. How to do that now? Replies next verse. Shri Krishna Sharanam Mama. 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 Abhyasa Yoga Himsena Chetasanaya Dhamina. Paramam Purusham Deyam Jati Parvam Chintayam. Bhagavan is helpless before this deluded jiva. And every teacher, every Mahatma, every saint has found himself in this position. Because this jiva always wants a quick fix. Doctors are helpless. Are all the doctors who sit here, so many of them sitting here. That patient comes and he wants that doctor must give him one injection, or one pill, and all his trouble must go. Correct or not? Correct. See, doctor tell him. He said exactly with the sadhaka. He goes before Bhagavan and Bhagavan must tell, do like that. And all his troubles must disappear. This is sadhaka. So, Bhagavan says, remember me your whole life and do your duty. How to do that? Surrender your mind and intellect to me. How to do that? Bhagavan says, now he has to revert back to the good old one technique only which is there in the whole universe. Which he told in the 6th chapter when Arjuna asked about the mind. And he's telling here again, there is only one antidote to all of it. Practice. Without practicing, he wants moksha. He doesn't want to do anything. Abhyasa yoga yuktena. Get yourself together and practice. Yoga yuktena means get yourself to together, pull yourself together and get down to some serious practice. Practice japa, practice meditation, practice the reading of Bhagavad Gita. Practice! You don't sit there and don't practice anything. And, but how I'll get this moksha? How I'll merge with you, Prabhu? You're only asking questions so far and practice? Nothing. So, whichever sadhana it is, from whatever level you are, you start practicing something very seriously. Shravanam is, of course, the first step. That's what you're doing now, right? You're all listening here. Those are listening on radio, on internet, this, that. Those are listening here live tonight, in person here tonight. This is Shravanam. But Shravanam is only the first step. After Shravanam, after listening, you have to go and do something. Listening alone is... See, after the body ingests the food, the body also digests the food. The body just doesn't ingest. It digests also. Then, absorb. assimilate all such things, eh? Metabolize. So many things the body does after that. In the very same way, when we listen here in Shravanam, whether Gyan Marg or Bhakti Marg, Shravanam is first, listening. After that, we have to actually do some serious sadhana, practice, abhyasa yoga, yoga yukte na. Then sixth chapter, abhyasa yana to kaunte, vera gena cha grihyate. So Bhagavan has to go back to, there's only one thing to do. The Lord himself becomes helpless. Now there's one, the simplest word, again he has to tell. Abhyasa yoga yukte na, chetasa na anya gamina. Don't let your mind wander here and there thinking about all other worldly, materialistic things. Let your mind be fixed on me. Even if you're looking at this worldly object, what you call a worldly object, see that this worldly object is fashioned out of, made out of existence. So that you have to practice. You go on doing it every day. That the object is made out of existence only. It exists or not? Every part of it exists. The space on this side exists and the space on that side exists. So the space also is made up of existence. Everything in the world is made up of existence. So when we see the same world, we see it with a different eye, with different goggles. So that has to be practiced. So that means, you know, chetasa na anya gamina. Chetasa, I mean, but don't let the mind wander into the worldliness of the world. Let it wander into the divinity of the world. Same world. Param purusham divyam yati parthanuchintan. Thinking about that reality, which is inherent in the universe, that person goes to that supreme reality. Shining, divine reality. He goes there. See the same world, but see it with a different eye. And that has to be practice. Abhyasa yoga yuktena. The practice is required. And now from the next verse, Bhagavan describes now that reality. Same reality which you are supposed to think about, reflect on. That reality is described in most wonderful, and it changes the meter. So we don't have a tune for that longer meter. Trishtup Chanda, we'll have to sing our ordinary Bhagavad Gita, regular Bhagavad Gita tune, which is also very divine. Now everything is divine.
Kavim Purana Manushasitaram.
Kavim Purana Manushasitaram.
Anoraniyam samanusmaredyaha.
Anoraniyam samanusmaredyaha.
Sarvasya dhataram achintya rupam.
Sarvasya dhataram achintya rupam.
Aditya varnam tamasaparasta.
Aditya varnam tamasaparasta.
Prayana kale manasachalena.
Prayana kale manasachalena.
Bhaktya yukto yoga balena chaiva.
Bhaktya yukto yoga balena chaiva.
Bhor madhye pranama vesha samyato.
Bhor madhye pranama vesha samyato.
Satam param purusham upaiti divyam.
Satam param purusham upaiti divyam.
Yadaksharam veda vido vadanti.
Yadaksharam veda vido vadanti.
Dishanti yadyatayo vitaragaha.
Dishanti yadyatayo vitaragaha.
Yadichanto brahmacharyam charanti.
Yadichanto brahmacharyam charanti.
Tatte padam sangrahena pravakshe.
Tatte padam sangrahena pravakshe.
Sarvadwarani samyamya.
Sarvadwarani samyamya.
Manohridini urdhyacha.
Manohridini urdhyacha.
Murdhnyadhayatmana pranam.
Murdhnyadhayatmana pranam. Pranam
asthito yoga dharanam.
Asthito yoga dharanam.
Omitye taksharam brahma.
Omitye taksharam brahma.
Yaharan mamanusmaran.
Yaharan mamanusmaran.
Yaprayati chajandeham.
Yaprayati chajandeham.
Sayati paramam gatim.
Sayati paramam gatim.
Sayati paramam gatim.
Sayati paramam gatim.
One of the nice verses. This 8th chapter is where, see, I keep saying that every night for every chapter, you know. People ask me, Swamiji, which is your favorite text? So I used to say one this text or that text, but after some years, my favorite text is the one I'm reading that time. Really, all of them are so nice. Shastra Gyan, Jnana Abhyas, which Bhagwan talks about. Jnana Abhyas we saw previously. The Lord himself mentioned this word. Jnana Abhyas. This is such a wonderful thing. You know how people get drunk with some intoxicant and all that kind of thing? If you really get into this thing, this will itself be an intoxicant. What better intoxicant to have? Shastra Abhyas, Jnana Abhyas. It's so wonderful. He says, this reality which you're supposed to reach, me, the absolute reality which you're supposed to reach is Kavim. Kavim means omniscient. Omniscient means knows Trikala, knows past, present and future. Just know yesterday only we saw that Bhagwan knows past, present and future of all beings because he is the background adhishtan, adhar of the universe. All things are playing off on him only. Like everything that passes across the screen, the screen, as though if it had knowledge, it would know because everything passed on the screen only. But Bhagwan is the infinite screen. Kavim, omniscient, Puranam, he is ancient. Puranam means eternal. Here, Puranam literally means ancient, but Bhagwan is before time, transcends time also. Puranam, Anushasitaram, what a wonderful word. Anushasitaram means the one who is the ordainer of all rules and laws that govern this universe. Ordainer and upholder also. Anushasitaram. Meaning to say that he is the one who is the embodiment itself of all laws and who holds them together so that you cannot transgress any. You may want to. You could break the law in Trinidad and Tobago, you know. And by the police and this and that. And that's everybody do. They break the law. But the law of karma, for example. Who you go by? You can't. There's nobody, isn't it? Let me tell you something. If you try to circumvent the law of karma, that's our next karma. That itself is another karma. So you going in quicksand. Nah. When you shake together the quicksand, you don't come up, you go down. So no. He's called Anushasitaram, the ordainer and upholder of all laws. You will realize that there are countless laws, so many which we don't even know. That the cells, nutrients will go into the cells and waste products will come out. You could control? Anybody know how to control that? I'll send nutrients inside and all this waste product and you Anushasitaram. There's a Lord who has made that law and he's the one who upholds the law and makes it happen. You have absolutely no control of a good thing. Because you know, anything we put in hand and we mess it up, isn't it? We mess it up, isn't it? Good thing we have no control. Anushasitaram, this word, that's what I mean. Sometimes you come across some word like this in Bhagavad Gita, you could go on all day. That's just now I mentioned the word Jnana Abhyas. You take that word and you go on reflecting. This is people are asking about sadhana and all. What are sadhana? You take that word, Anushasitaram, the one who is the ordainer and upholder of all laws in the universe. You go on reflecting on that word. Amazing. We don't want to reflect. Now we're reflecting tomorrow. You know, if OPEC countries cut back the production, oil prices will go up, you know, things will get better in Trinidad. See, what we're reflecting on. And that also is up in the air. Nobody knows who will do what. And the stock market people, they're only waiting for some one word from somebody. And the whole thing become volatile. Jumping you all about. You see? Nothing real or anything sure, nothing firm. But people reflecting on that only. Whole day. So reflect on this. Anushasitaram is called as Anoraniyam samanusmaretyah. I mean, remember this, which is called Anoraniyam. Anoraniyam means the subtlest of the subtle. Among subtle things in the universe, these things are, it is in our Sanskrit, there is something called as sukshma and sukshmataram. Subtle, subtler, subtlest. And there's something called as stula. Stula means gross, like this thing. Gross thing means all your five senses can perceive it. They call gross. And the lesser number of senses that can perceive something, that is called as subtle. And then that subtle also, there are less and less and less. And some things, like for example, your karma. Sanchita karma. Who knows? No sense organ could peep into that storehouse, Sanchita karma. All your karma are period, but you know. But it's there. Because all your karma coming out every day. How you get up with a headache today? Karma! But you didn't know. You didn't know where it was. Because sukshmataram. Sukshmataram it will be. Bhagwan is only sukshmataram. The supreme reality. Subtlest of the subtle. In the other way, in Sanskrit, anoraniyam. Some anusmaraya. Have you remembered that well? Now this is the practice which you were just talking about. Go on remembering. Bhagwan, you see, this is gross. The air which is here, that is subtler, you see, because all five senses cannot perceive the air. So to reflect on the word itself, the air is subtle. The space is even subtler than the air. And then, see, this Lord who is even beyond space. Space you could still divide, you know. Put a wall here, your space. My space. Isn't it? You could divide space also. Divide Bhagwan, no? What wall do you put? So, he is subtlest of the subtle. I mean, remember that well. Sam anusmaritya. Remembering it well. That Bhagwan. This is the practice. Sarvasya dhataram achintya rupam aditya varnam tamasap parastat. All the words deserve such great reflection on them. Sarvasya dhataram. Sarvasya dhataram means he is the ordainer of all things in the world, not only rules, but of all things. He is also the upholder, the adhishtan, the substratum of all things. This word has all of these meanings. Sarvasya dhataram. Upon which all things rest. So, you know, we know this thing is resting on the earth. Right? And the earth is there swirling in space and held together by some laws of gravity and magnetism and all that kind of thing, what you call forces, centripetal and centrifugal forces and all that thing acting, and the earth is held there. So that force is holding the earth. Who is holding the force?
<Not me>.
Huh? The what? Yeah. Force. So, in the movie and all,
sorry.
Yeah. In the movie and all, you'll have, who is holding the force there and some word, but then you'll ask who is holding him. So the final upholder of all things is this Supreme Lord. Sarvasya dhataram achintya rupam. Unthinkable he is. Means our mind cannot conceive of, conceptualize that reality. Because why? The mind is such a finite, not only finite, but it has so many debilities. Besides being finite, so many debilities of the mind. How it will ever conceptualize or conceive of an infinite reality that is perfection itself? When the mind is full of all imperfection, you know, it cannot. Therefore, achintya rupam. What do you have to do? The one who has this mind, he has to transcend the mind. The salt doll, when he wants to know the depth of the ocean, he has to dive in. But when he dives in, Ram Nam Satya. Gone. They are not dull to ask any question thereafter. What is the depth of the ocean? The human being, the jiva, he goes on asking, what is God like? Where is God like? How is he like? All sorts of questions he goes on asking. Dive in. So in other words, not that the human being will come to know God. The human being has to disappear in his effort to know God. Because as long as he is there, questions will be. As long as we are there, questions will be there. Therefore, there is no real answer to all questions. Somebody asks you, what is the taste of sugar? Some Martian who has never tasted sugar. Right? Suppose I am a Martian and I asked you, describe to me the taste of sugar. Try. where you will start? And a simple thing like sugar, you can't describe, you will describe God. Sugar is like honey. The Martian say, what is honey? Right? Because in Mars, they are no bees. You're going circles only. So here is called achintyam, because it's beyond the mind. Ooh, way beyond the mind. And the mind cannot come close. Aditya varnam tamasap prastat. He is like this, the shining sun beyond all darkness. One day, Aruna, you know, Aruna is the charioteer of Surya Bhagavan. Arun comes out there driving seven horses. He's in front, Arun. He's called as Dawn also. That's why the meaning of the word Arun is Dawn. He comes out wearing, driving this chariot with seven horses. Look how she's new. Seven horses, seven colors of the rainbow and all that. Surya Bhagavan coming behind. Arun driving the chariot coming in front with seven horses. One day, Arun told Surya Bhagavan, he said, Prabhu, I see God, I see Master. He said, you know, it has something called darkness. Surya Bhagavan said, really? What is this darkness? He said, come, under my bed. I will show you. Under my bed, always dark. I'm going to show you this darkness under my bed. He carries Surya Bhagavan, Master. He said, I'm going to show you this darkness. Surya Bhagavan, go on, you know. Wait, there's a darkness there. If Surya Bhagavan is there, how can there be? Darkness. Beyond, he doesn't even know what is darkness. And he can never know. It is not possible for Surya Bhagavan to know what is darkness. Where you'll go to see it? In the very same way, it is not possible for the absolute reality to know what is ignorance. Because the absolute reality is of the nature of pure consciousness, awareness. How will you ever know what is ignorance? This is the metaphor which is being used to teach that. In the reality, there is no such thing as ignorance. In our mind? Nothing but ignorance. Yeah? Amazing thing. Aditya varanam tamasaprastada. Realities of like the sun. Beyond all darkness. Doesn't know what is darkness. Prayana kale manasachalena. If at the time of death we hold our mind steady now, not thinking about all of these worldly things, you know, he's thinking about the shop. It's time he's dying now. Brahma, Vishnu, Mahesh, Ganesh, who is gone. No shop come back. So he's not able to hold his mind steady on Brahma, Vishnu, Mahesh and Ganesh. Manasa achalena. The mind held steady, not moving. On this, which is that's being described, Kavim Purana Manusha Sitaram. This is the practice. Throughout the life, and then at the time of death, it will be possible. No shortcut to progress in spirituality. If you want to get to this reality, you will have to pay the price. Kabir Daji says the price is what, you know? The price is your whole self. You will have to give your whole self. This is it. Bhaktya yukto yoga balena chaiva. With deep devotion in the heart now. And yuktaha, pulling yourself together. Yoga bal, with the power of yoga. It's which you have practiced. Sadatad bhava bhavitaha. Practice throughout the life. And if you have not practiced any yoga in the last, where you go practice? You're bringing yourself together, collecting yourself, and if that has not been practiced in the life, time to go what you will practice. Bhurmadhye pranama veshasam. Means now, see, this is the art of dying in Hinduism. Eh? It's art of living, but it's also art of dying. The art of dying is perfected through the art of living. We die in such a way that we don't have to die again. This is the art of dying. But that really involves the art of living. I live a life of sadhana throughout the life. Sadatat bhava bhavitaha, thinking about God all the time. Everything I see it with the eye of God. You have to read the Sri Ramakrishna Paramahamsa has a nice book like this called as the Gospel of Sri Ramakrishna. You have to go through that. Now see, this is all practice we are talking about. Huh? Read his gospel. You'll see that there is nothing that... I am amazed at this saint. There is nothing that Mahatma could see and not see God in it. Anything. It's amazing. So if I have practiced it like that, seeing God in all things throughout my life, says at the end, I'll be able to bring that prana to the middle. Bhur madhye prana ma vesha samyak satam param purusham paiti divyam. He is able to let the prana leave through the upper channels of his personality. He says when the prana dissolves through the other lower channels of the personality, then he goes into monkey and donkey and frog, and he's born as that. When we bring the prana and it leaves through the Brahma Rantra. But it comes through stages, concentrating it in the middle of the forehead, he says, and then letting it leave through the Brahma Rantra. He let the life force leave through the Brahma Rantra. Says Satam Param Purusham Upaiti. He goes to a supreme state. Divyam, which is divine. Yad aksharam veda vidaha vadanti vishanti yad yatayo vitaragaha yadichanto brahmacharyam taranti tapte padam sangrahena pravakshe. That state, which is sought by all great practitioners, rishi munis, which they practice brahmacharya for, which they desire, yadichantaha, they practice brahmacharya, and into which they enter after having given up all things of this world, that akshara, imperishable state, which is spoken of by all the knowers of truth. He says, now, sangrahena pravakshe, I'm going to talk to you about, but why do you think you've been talking about all the time? I'm going to talk to you about that state. In other words, well, this is the mark of a good teacher. They go on teaching, I remember, after going to ashram, some question I asked to Swamiji. I don't remember the question now because of Swamiji's reply only. I asked some question based on his lecture. Swamiji said, don't worry about it, you go come again. So I left it right there. Forgot question, and when he came again, I learned it that time. Whatever. You see, so the mark of a good teacher, he goes on repeating the same things from different angle, because everybody is different, you know. Somebody may care. Look here, one fellow, his dog was sick, so he go on and buy some medicine and he put it in a spoon and he hold the dog mouth now, and you have to get his fingers inside the dog mouth to open the mouth to put this medicine. Well, the dog protesting, which dog want their mouth to open like this from the side and all kind of thing. He hold, try for a good while to put that in, that can't, you didn't succeed at all. You open the dog mouth with one hand and put medicine with difficult task. While struggling like that, the medicine fall down in the ground, and he get vexed too, get angry, leave the dog, leave him. gone and put back the bottle and get something to clean up this medicine. When he come back, he see the dog licking the medicine. All by himself, licking from the ground. Mm. The method of administration is administering the medicine. The method of administering the medicine is wrong. So that means for a human being, the spoon will work. But for a dog, it will not work. Different methods of administering medicine will work differently for different. In the very same way, you know, the knowledge of Vedanta and the Shastras and all will be understood differently by different people. So he administers in different ways. So one will understand from this way, another will understand from that way. So he's saying the same thing. So he says, all the great sages and saints and all the great knowers of truth, they speak about this. Yet aksharam purusham, that supreme reality. That I'm going to speak to you, my dear Arjuna, how to speak to you about it and how to reach it also. Now see this. Oh, we chanted already. He says, sarva dwarani samyamya mano hridi niruddhya cha. Means, sarva dwarani means, dwara means door. And we saw in one previous verse, we saw it already in the seventh chapter. He says, nava dware pure dehi. In this body there are 9 doors. I told you, na? 9 doors. 7 right here in the head itself, and 2 lower doors, excretion and procreation, upper tears. So there are 7 in the head and 2 lower in the body. 9 doors in his body. He says, sarva dwarani means all of these doors. What to do? Samyak mano hridi nirudhya means you close them off and bring them to concentrate in the heart. The eyes want to go out this side, the ears want to go out. You close them and bring them into the heart. Murdhnya dhyatmana pranam. And the remember this topic is going on is dying. So this time of death, close all these doors and bring their attention in the heart. And the life force, you bring it in the head. Bring it so that it will leave from the now, see, this topic which is really going on here is part of what we call as yoga. Yoga darshana in our tradition. In yoga, this is all what they practice. That's why they say Bhagavad Gita is a universal text. It speaks Advaita Vedanta, it speaks Sankhya, it speaks yoga, it speaks, you know, Dvaita, everything is there to be found here. So the people from yoga, they love these verses and all. Yoga darshana, the Patanjali people. This is what they practice. And then you gave the word abhyas there also. So this is also there to be practiced. In Chinmayanishan, we don't practice these type of things. You'll have to get a sampradaya where this is the main practice. We practice what is there in 6th chapter. This is 8th chapter. And parts of this we practice, what? Remembering God and doing your duty. That we practice. Now this yoga practice of bringing all the senses inside and lifting the prana from chakra to chakra and letting the prana emerge from the Brahmarandra chakra on the top. Anahat chakra it is called sometimes. Different words in different sampradaya and all. This is what is being spoken about. Pranam astito yoga dharanam, holding now in this is the practice of in the practice of yoga. Om iti eka aksharam brahma vyaharan maman smaran. And remembering me, who is said to be Om, the imperishable Om. Sayati tyajatyandeham sayati paramam gatim. He reaches the supreme state. So, it is the art of dying from practice of yoga or the art of dying from the practice of your ordinary karma, remembering God, whichever you want. So, now if you want to practice this yoga, you will have to go deeper into that sampradaya and find that. No, one more thing I must tell you. These type of sampradayas have all gone. We don't have them anymore. Kundalini and proper practice of kundalini and raising of the kundalini through the different chakras and all that kind of practices is very, very rare now. And we have some bogus practices there, many of those, but true practice of this type of yoga is very rare and all. So, in this practice, what is important is given in the next verse. In all of this practice, whether you, through the karma yoga, you do your work, yudhyacha, do your work, do your duty, and remember me, or you sit down and practice yoga and bring this prana up, the chakras, and release it through the brahmaranda. Whether you do that, what is important is perfect concentration and engagement of our mind, intellect, and all our faculties. 100%, that is spoken about in the next verse that we will see tomorrow.